Excited, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so on behalf of Ruchi ma'am and Lexicon Kalyani Nagar, I welcome you to your first online teaching. And enjoy it, focus, and learn as much as you can. And congratulations on this great jump to class 10. So just as we start, I have already forwarded the notes of the first chapter of Letter to God. Have you all gone through it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, so I just wanted to gist it up today in case it was difficult or anything you all did not understand. I just want you all to go through the PPT that I've just prepared to make you all understand, because this chapter is really important. I've seen repeated questions every time during the boards. Even this year, they had a question, an 8-marker question from this chapter. Okay, so it's important to understand the first chapter. Clear? So I'll just share a PPT where I've tried to make it a little easy for you all. Okay. So this is the chapter, the author G.L. Fuentes, and he has depicted the faith of anybody, the unwavering faith of a farmer in God. The farmer is Lencho over here. You understand the meaning of unwavering? Something, you understand? It's something which is very steady. Somebody who has, if you have read the story, you've understood how he have asked for those 100 pesos and how he believed that God is going to send him the amount. Clear? So the, yes, so the setup is a Latin American country. They've not mentioned the name, but from the facts provided in the story, we understand that the setup is a Latin American country, and he's the protagonist of the story. Always, I've repeated this word protagonist. You understand the main character of the story. There are questions asked, who is the protagonist of the story? So of this story, Lencho is the protagonist, the main character. Clear, everybody?
Yeah.
Yes, so now, basically what the background was, he had a field of ripe corns and he was waiting for a downpour, for a good harvest. But then suddenly a hailstorm started and it destroyed his crops. Clear? So pesos is the monetary unit that's mentioned over here, the monetary unit of Mexico. Clear? That's the monetary unit they've mentioned over here. So it destroyed his crops, and then he was like, how to feed his family. He was totally devastated and he did not understand how to feed his family for the rest of the year. So he writes a letter to God asking for 100 pesos. Clear? But then the letter reaches the post office and people make fun of him over there. So then what happens? The postmaster understood the concern. And so he decides to collect money and send him. But he could only collect 70 pesos. So then he sends those 70 pesos to Lencho. But when he opens the envelope and he sees that he has received only 70 pesos, he was very angry. He understood that God has sent him 100 pesos, but the post office people, he considered them as a bunch of crooks. He thought those 30 pesos they have taken away. And they have just sent him 70 pesos. This faith, that blind faith that he, two things we learn over here. I've just mentioned over here, just check. One is blind faith. And the other is corruption. So the blind faith, when we're talking about, it's talking about the blind faith that Lencho had on God. He knew that God has, it was confirmed that 100 pesos were sent by God and those 30 pesos were taken by the post office people. He never understood the concern of the postmaster over there. So again, he writes another letter to God demanding the rest of the money. Clear?
Yes.
So it shows the blind faith of Lencho over here. This is the basic learning that you learn. And corruption, if I talk about corruption over here, he had something in his back of his mind about the conflict that we have in between humans, the corruption that we are facing always. Clear? So two learnings that Lencho and the post office people. From Lencho, we learned how to have blind faith in God. And from the post office people, from there we see how corruption has changed Lencho's mind. He couldn't believe the postmaster or the post office people. Clear. So there are certain themes that we are talking about, what the story generally focuses. Questions can revolve around all these things. Questions will not be directly asked. The 8-marker questions, as we always know, that they're little bit indirect questions, as we have discussed in the class, always. So first we talk about Lencho's innocent faith in God and how he knows that God is going to respond, but through different ways, through his peculiar channels. Over here, who's the channel? The postmaster. Clear? Over yes. here, the postmaster is the channel through whom God has responded. God has sent him those 70 pesos. Clear? So God is ready to fulfill man's urgent, legitimate desire. Any legitimate desire means something which depends on logic. You can defend it. His desire, he knew that God is going to fulfill his desire, and he had faith in God. And that's how his faith was rewarded. But still that suspicion was there in Lencho's mind that the office employees were crooks. He did not believe that the postmaster could think about him and send those 70 pesos. Even after receiving the money, it was not there in his mind at all. Clear? So yeah. This was a basic theme that the story revolves around. And generally, you need to understand three things. The blind faith, the corruption, Lencho's belief in how humans are, his idea about human beings. There are two things in the story. There are two kinds of conflicts, which is a very important question that can always be asked. It's between humans and nature. There are two kinds of conflict. If I talk about conflict between humans and nature over here, Pranav, can you tell me? What do you understand by this conflict, humans and nature? Any idea? You said you have gone through the story. I'd send you a link. Did you go through that link?
Yes, ma'am.
So the complete story was narrated over there. So what do you understand when I talk about a conflict between human and nature? Okay, if I tell you over here, I talk about Lencho and the hailstorm. Clear? Is it clear? When I'm talking about, he was expecting a good harvest. Clear? And then the hailstorm comes. It destroys his complete field of crops. So that's a conflict which humans are facing with nature. Clear? He's helpless over here. Lencho is helpless. So he's not able to solve this problem that nature has sent down on him. Clear? On the other hand, we talk about the conflicts between humans themselves. The belief that we cannot believe each other. There's a conflict between each people, like two people. Over here, we talk about the post office people and Lencho. There's a lot of corruption which is there at the back of the mind. And that's the reason we cannot believe each other. So there's a conflict. There's always a dispute between humans, human being themselves. Clear? So the two kinds of dispute or conflict, whichever you consider to be mentioned over here, is if the question is like, what are the two kinds of conflicts in the story? So we talk about the conflict, the dispute, the disagreement between Lencho and nature. He never wanted. He never agreed to a hailstorm which nature had sent down. And again, the conflict between the post office people and the postmaster as well as Lencho. The postmaster also did not agree to the post office people. So there's a conflict over there as well. Clear? And over here between Lencho and the post office people. So between each human being, there's disagreement. They do not agree to each other. So this conflict exists. It's very natural. That is why the author has portrayed on these two kinds of conflict. Anybody has any question regarding the conflict that has been mentioned in the story, the two kinds of conflict?
No.
No.
No, ma'am.
I have 10th A and B both over here.
Yes, ma'am.
Anybody from 10th A? Any doubt? 10th B?
No,
ma'am.
Well, understood the story?
Yes.
Understood the two terms, blind faith, corruption, how it has been displayed or portrayed in the story?
Yes, ma'am.
Understood the two different kinds of conflicts in the story? It's very important. I want you all to note down the keywords, blind faith, corruption. I want you all to note down the two kinds of conflicts in the story. I hope everybody is carrying a notebook.
Yes, ma'am.
I want you all to note down the two different kinds of conflicts in the story. If I go back to the slide, the basic theme, I talk about man's innocent faith in God. I want you all to note down. Man's innocent faith in God. How his faith was rewarded. How God responds in different ways to different people, to different channels, which you never expect. The trust between human beings, the mutual trust that has been shown in this story. These are the basic points. If you understand, you'll be able to understand, answer any question in the story. Dear children?
Yes, ma'am.
Anything? Any question?
No.
Okay. So there are two questions that I've I had sent you a few questions in that work, that note that was mailed to you. You have seen some basic questions were given.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you all gone through seven questions were given?
Yes, ma'am.
Other than those questions, I wanted you all to answer these two questions as 8-marker questions. Can you quickly copy these down? Do you think that Lencho was right to call the post office employees a bunch of crooks? It's an open-ended answer. Okay. So it's an open-ended answer. If you think it's yes, you give your own justification. If you think it's no, you give your own justification. It should be at least 150 to 200 words. I want you all to increase the word limit this time a little bit. We had done 120 to 130, 150. I wanted to reach 200 this time.
No problem.
You can give your justification for this. Why or why not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, there's another question. Why and how did the postmaster help Lencho? Both 8-markers, same word limit. Note it down?
No, ma'am.
One second.
Okay, yes, go on.
Done.
Why and how did the postmaster help Lencho? Okay, when we are talking about why he helped Lencho, you have to give a proper justification for that. As a human being, why one person wants to help another person? That's the justification. Even the fact provided over here in the story, and the other post office people did not want to help him. But still, the postmaster went ahead and helped Lencho. So you have to give a proper reason for why. And how is simple? It's given over here. How he collected the money. Clear?
Yeah.
Ma'am.
Yeah. And when you're writing why Lencho was... Why was it not correct from the point of Lencho that he called the post office people a bunch of crooks? What can be the reason why he was not right?
Because the postmaster wanted to help him.
Yes. Yes, right, Dave. The postmaster wanted to help him. The trust factor did not work over here. Yeah. Yes. Anybody who has who has the answer of like he agrees to the fact that do you think like Joe was right to call the post somebody who thinks he was right?
If we think from Lencho's point of view, he was not wrong, because in today's world, every field has corruption. And when he has asked for 100 pesos and he gets little bit less, so the first thing which will come to his mind will be corruption. So I don't think that he had fault in his side.
So you need to give your proper justification in the second paragraph. First, the introductory paragraph, two paragraphs for an 8-marker answer. And the second paragraph has to be a proper justification. So can you complete a proper paragraph with that justification?
Yes.
Who was it?
Yes.
Who was that who answered?
Saurav.
Saurav, okay, yes. So Saurav, you have to give your own justification for that. You're right. From your point of view, you can give that answer. It's an open-ended answer, so it's right. So if you think that he was not... He was right from, because as a human being, it's very difficult to trust. Once we have gone through this, the conflict between human beings. So from his point of view, he's right. Yeah. So now, anybody has any question regarding this lesson? Just because you all had gone through the chapter, gone through the content, I just briefed it today. I just gave a short summary of the complete lesson and all the key words, the key points that you need to remember while attempting any question, while answering any question of this chapter. So any thing in the notes that you all did not understand that was sent, or anything that I have discussed now?
No, ma'am.
Everything is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the site that was sent to you all, if you all go through it, there are some grammar exercises given along with it. Just after the lesson, there are a few grammar exercises which you'll get when you get your book. I want you all to solve those grammar exercises as well, which is given along with the chapter.
Yes, ma'am.
There are a few words which you need to understand, word meanings, the form of fill in the blanks that's given over there. You scroll down when you visit that site, you scroll down and few grammar exercises with some words. There are homonyms, there are homophones, there are few exercises given over there. In case you don't understand that, when we meet next time, you can always come up with your doubts. Clear? And one more worksheet that was sent to you, a grammar worksheet. You all have received a grammar worksheet?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Wherever you all are maintaining a notebook where you all are noting down all the question answers, you all are writing the answers.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Notebook. Yes, y'all can carry on with the work when the school reopens in this particular notebook. So I want you all to write down all the answers that I had sent along with the notes, as well as these 8 markers. Those answers are all 2 markers. Okay. You'll know the word limit. It can be 50 to 80 words. Clear?
Okay.
I want you all to increase the word limit now. You all had done till 60, isn't it, in class 9? So please increase the word limit. You all have to, at least, it's 50 to 80 words now. I want 80 words, actually, a proper answer. So those are all 2 markers, and these 2 questions are of 8 marks each. Clear? And the worksheet has your rearranging, your editing, omitting, and your fill in the blanks. For rearranging, only if grammatically the answer is correct, it will be accepted. Always remember this. You cannot have multiple answers. You can have maximum 2 only when you change the subject and the object. Remember this. You can just change the position of the subject or the object, passive or active voice. You remember? We all have done in previous classes.
Yeah.
Any other answer for rearranging will not be accepted. Throughout the session, you'll remember this. So keeping this in mind, you have to remember all the answers. When you're writing the answers, you have to remember this. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt with the worksheet, grammar worksheet, or your literature question answers?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
All clear? The lesson is clear? It's easy?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Chapter is easy?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So we meet after the school reopens. We can answer any question from this lesson.
Yes,
ma'am. For opening
yes,
the book.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Without opening the book?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes. Okay. Easy, Pratham?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Anya, done? Anya? Aditya? Okay. Inal?
Yes, ma'am.
All done. So it's easy for everybody. Palak, understood the chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine.
Ma'am.
Okay. So the ones who have not come online, please convey this. I want you all to share the questions with them. These two 8 markers, rest they have already received. Okay. And the grammar worksheet, whatever I've mentioned for rearranging, I want you all to share it with them. Clear? Everybody, Aditya,
yes,
will do it for me. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Right, children, was it a fruitful class with your teacher here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so we are going to meet very often through this channel. And all those who were not able to connect to us today, please tell them that we're going to meet tomorrow again. Maybe with English or maybe with some other class, but your teachers are going to contact you through the Zoom classes. And whatever your doubts are, we've asked you to put yourself on mute. So whatever your doubts are, when the teacher asks you some question, please unmute yourself, show the video as well, and then ask your question and answer.